Sir Oliver Humperdinck, we got a man right here, I think it's mad with the world, and that's Roddy Piper. Of course, he and Jack Briscoe now in a real tremendous feud over this Mid-Atlantic Championship.
That's exactly right. Roddy Piper is indeed a man of the world. He's a great wrestler, a great gentleman, and I'm proud to say a personal friend of mine.
I tell you, you're the only person I've ever heard say in my life that Roddy Piper was a gentleman. I got to tell you that. Nobody else has said that.
Man enjoys the finer things of life, Bob. He enjoys fine cuisine, beautiful women, fancy cars. A man after my own heart, if I might say so myself. Now you see Mr. Piper working on that head, controlling that head. Now this guy, he's wrestling. I haven't had a chance to
Jimmy
see him before.
Jimmy Panner, right.
But a big guy. He's a big guy. He's got a large chest, big arms, and he could spell a little trouble. He looks like he's got some power behind
him. Well, the first time that we've had an opportunity to see Jimmy Panner also, I got to say this. It's a whale of a way to start out here on television against a guy like Roddy Piper.
That's exactly right. You have to take off your hat to this kid to step into the ring with a man like Piper who will do just about anything to win. I got to admire that in a man, too. He's got tremendous desire. He'll do anything he has to do to win. And that makes a successful business person a successful wrestler.
Good takedown. Armbar right here now by Panner.
Now, I'm sure going through Roddy's mind right now is a series of moves that he could do to escape that armbar that he's in right now. He's always thinking. The man is perpetually in thought. He's got something in mind right now, I can tell. He's got him backed up against the rope.
Oh, we're going to get a clean break. Piper. Well, Panner
great
breaks.
Sportsman.
Piper,
great sportsman.
Piper backs away.
Outstanding sportsman. Fireman's carry takedown. Beautiful.
He
hangs onto that arm.
Very well. That's right.
He's got that arm locked up good and tight. Roddy knows what he's doing. He takes his time. He's very methodical. He's a thinking individual. And he's a very, very tough, excellent wrestler.
He is a whale of a wrestler in the ring. Well, he went to the hair for the takedown on Panner there. I got to say this, though, about Piper. And Piper admits it. He goes out and gets guys like Morocco. Don Morocco, we saw at the beginning of our program, to do some of his dirty work for him.
That's the way you could put it, Bob. The man recognizes talent. Look at this. He's opening up now. He's opening up on the man. Roddy Piper's got an explosive temper. He's got a very flaring temper. And when he pops that temper, I don't want to be around. There he goes.
Lemming cutter. Hard to that turnbuckle. Boom, right into the windpipe.
I don't care.
It looked like an open hand to me, Bob, but...
He's got the young man hurt right now.
Come on!
No doubt.
Piper, when he hurts you, he wants to keep just pouring it on.
He likes to maintain control of the situation. There is a difference there between being deliberately vicious and maintaining control. Maintaining control is what Roddy is doing right now and very well indeed. He's got this man right where he wants him. Big slam coming up. Look at this. Boom! Almost right through the mat. Roddy's in control, complete control. He's in the driver's seat. He knows it. He's confident. He's good, and he knows it.
Well, he said, count him, and Piper lifted him up off of the mat.
Perhaps could have had a pin there. Perhaps could have had a pin, not satisfied, maybe wanting to deal out a little bit more punishment. You know, Roddy might be making a statement right now to Jack Briscoe or Jay Youngblood or Ricky Steamboat or these guys. Don't mess with me. A lot of times they use a guy as an example, and I'm afraid this man he's wrestling tonight is just going to be made an example of.
I think you're right. He is definitely trying to send a message, and now with the front face lock, he's really putting a pressure on him again. He reached out to get all the extra leverage he could.
He's stretched out there. He's stretched out, and he's got that pressure on the neck, bending that neck forward. It's a front face lock, Bob. Tremendous pressure on the neck. He went for the arm, but you see Piper countered beautifully. Pulled that arm back out of there, didn't let him have it. Roddy's still in the driver's seat, maintaining control. Very important in professional wrestling.
Look at him go. There's like a temper. Wild man in There's a ring when he turns
again.
It loose.
There's that temporary
He completely
flare.
Loses his head.
Back suit play.
He won't get up from that. One,
hooks
two,
that leg.
Three. When Piper hooks the leg after that, it's
excellent.
All over.
Excellent match. There's a man with desire, with man with knows what he wants, and a man that'll go out and get what he wants. Roddy Piper will always be successful.
All right, fans, watch it here in slow motion and watch him really go to work.
He's working on that back there. He knows what he wants to do. It's just a matter of setting the man up, getting him in the position to do it. He's working again on him.
Looks like he goes berserk right here. Just wild, like a wild man.
There's that temper again. He's got desire. He's got drive. He's down. He's pounding on the man. He's working on that neck, head, and shoulder area. He knows what he wants to do. He knows he wants to get him set up for that back suit play. He's working on that area now. Here he goes into it. Watch this. He hooks his man right up, way up in the air. Drives right straight down on that canvas, a head and neck and shoulders.
It's all over. Yes, sir, fans. At that point, there you have the winner, Roddy Piper.